I'm Chloe Fontain, and you're watching The Buzz on DPTV Networks. It seems like there are a lot of sites for people who are looking to cheat, whether it's Ashley Madison, SeekingArrangements.com, SugarDaddies.com, and the Casual Encounters section of Craigslist. And let's not forget apps like Tinder, which lets you locate people within miles of you. So, it makes me wonder, whatever happened to monogamy? Is that something of the past? Is that an unrealistic view of today's relationships? I'm here in Union Square, and I want to ask some people to find out. Do you think that being monogamous in, say, like in a dating relationship, that's a thing of the past, or it should still be upheld today?
Me? Oh, I mean, I don't know.
I can say, as a married woman, absolutely. My husband's my best friend, and I wouldn't change him for anything else.
And as a married woman of 37 years, I say, absolutely, my husband's my best friend.
So have
what for 3 years? Absolutely, he's watching our baby at home.
I have a boyfriend almost a year, and I mean, I'm not trying to get married anytime soon, that's for sure. But yeah, that's what you do. You get married.
But do you think it would be okay if he was sleeping around with other people?
No, of course not. That's not him. Yeah.
What about the popularity of sites like Ashley Madison? Why do you think they're so popular with married?
Those are men that just don't know what to do with themselves, and they're I don't know, they're
dead.
Those women are crazy. They're like, oh, I'll just stay with them maybe because they have, like, make millions of dollars probably.
So neither of you would ever allow, like, an open relationship or anything like that?
No.
No. Absolutely not.
That's just married.
I don't feel
it
need
be like
that.
The thing in Brooklyn with all those hipsters, sure. That's like the thing, like, oh, it's too cool to get married now. Like, there's that thing. I know people that are like that.
We have a relative who's one of those, and she's happily married. With no open relationship.
With the popularity of sites like Ashley Madison, and you're always hearing celebrities coming out talking about, like, oh, they slept with the nannies and whatever. What do you think about monogamy in a relationship, in any kind of relationship? Do you think it's something that's a thing of the past, or people should expect that their significant other is sleeping with other people, or what?
I don't think they should expect that. It's wrong. Really, if you have a significant other, there's a reason why they're your significant other.
Okay, how about?
I agree. That's my wife.
So I guess neither of you will be hooking up on Tinder or Ashley Madison.
No. We're married.
So. Love early. We'll ride it out.
Very happy for you guys. Thank you.
Actually, you know, it's sad, but it seems like it's something of the past. I think monogamy is. Especially in the city, I don't really think there's more divorce, more people being unfaithful, probably than any time in our history. You know what I mean? So no, I don't think it's valid at all. Tinder, plenty of fish, fling, all those sites are really ruining the way how people that natural progression respecting one another. See what I mean?
You touched on an important fact that the city, do you feel like it's because there's so many options in the city, so many people?
Absolutely. You know, I've been all over the place, and New York's one place I would say that since there's such a variety of people, it seems that people feel like they can just throw people away. You know, that value's not there whatsoever at all.
I definitely feel that monogamy is not a thing of the past. I think using outlets like Tinder or whatever apps that allow for that.
Yeah.
Well, I think that those apps are moving with our generation, and it's like we're the millennials. We're changing the way how we live based on our opportunities that come at us. Stop laughing. But I don't think it's a thing of the past. Everyone has their own views, you know?
So the thing is, like you said, you're a millennial, and that's the apps that are targeting you. So if that's how your generation is thinking, then would anyone want to get married or want to be in a monogamous relationship? Because you're so used to sleeping with so many different people, why would you want to go to just being with one?
I mean, I personally, I don't have a Tinder, but I don't think that really correlates with sleeping with how many people. I don't think it correlates with how many people you sleep with, how many people you date. I just think it's another way to meet new people. People use that for different reasons, and that's their own business, but I don't think it affects anything with your views on monogamy or a person's view on monogamy.
How about you, ma'am?
It's just a different outlet, right?
It's just a different outlet. It's like going to a, like in the 50s when they go to the drive-ins, or in the 70s they go to discos. Our generation, uses social media to meet people and to meet people, and it's basically a platform.
What do you feel about sites like Ashley Madison or Seeking Arrangements for?
I've never heard of those.
I mean, I don't think humans are naturally monogamous, and especially with long lifespans, it seems like it's unlikely that you'll be with one person exclusively for your entire life. Also, I think that the sort of like Western ideal of a soulmate leads people to believe that you can get everything you need from one person, and I think that that's kind of foolish too. Like, one person will probably never meet all of the things that you're looking for.
Now, do you think that when you're dating or in a relationship, you should tell the person this information to let them know, like, hey, you know, I'm not looking for maybe one person. Maybe one person can fulfill all my needs, so I might need to look to other people for that.
I mean, absolutely. You have to be honest with whatever it is you're looking for. And, you know, it's a tricky balance because developing intimacy is sort of this reciprocal back and forth where, like, I reveal something about myself, some vulnerability, and then you show me that you're not going to hurt me with it, and then you reveal something, and then we, you know, slowly open up to each other. So it's a question of, like, when do you say things like that? But it should come out pretty quickly, I think. Those sort of beliefs and expectations.
And do you also think that, or the lack of monogamy or people looking for several partners, is something more common in the city? Or if you're from a small town, I feel like they'll marry young and they'll just have kids and they'll stay with one person forever. Where in a big city, they're more prone to looking for different partners or cheating or things like that. Do you think that's true?
I guess there's probably something about, yeah, just the amount of supply versus demand, perceived options. You know, if you come from somewhere that's just more provincial, then you know what you know.
I don't think monogamy is a thing of the past. I think it's still important to a lot of people, but certainly a lot of people are experimenting with trying open relationships, and, you know, good on them.
Do you think it's because they're living, say, in a big city where you have a lot of options, or is it just something of the time?
That probably has to do with living in a big city.
Well, I don't think it's anything new, really. People have been doing it since the beginning of the opposite sex. And they'll probably be doing it till the end of the opposite sex. I don't see any laws stopping them. If it is, it would be hardwired by now, because it's hardwired the other way.
Do you think then spouses should expect that the other is cheating, or?
Well, not necessarily. There are some people, I would say 1 out of 100, that won't, but that's only on one side. Maybe on the other side, the other person is not doing it, but maybe thinking about it.
Do you think it was something common since a long time ago, or is more popular now?
No, I think it's about the same. The only thing that would make it different now is the ratio of human beings in comparison to what there were, say, 5,000 years ago.
Monogamy comes with maturity. You can't want to be monogamous if you're not mature enough. So I think at a certain age, when you're mature enough to really want to be invested in one person, I think you can do it. It's not really one age. You know, you can't be old or you can be young, or, you know, it doesn't really matter the age. But when you're mature enough, basically, when you settle down and figure out, okay, I want to be with one person, I think that's when monogamy comes in.
So you do still believe that people do want to be with one person for the rest of their life?
Of course. Nobody's going to want you for the, you know, everybody's not going to want you for the rest of your life, you know. It just becomes with a lot of trial and error. Once you go through a lot of different people and you see, you know, different relationships, you learn different things, you realize, okay, dating is okay, but you kind of want that one person to be with. So, like I said, it comes with maturity and kind of trial and error of dating when you're younger, basically.
What are your opinions on the popularity of cheating sites like Ashley Madison?
I don't know. I think sites like, I mean, everybody doesn't want to be in a relationship, obviously, or some people would want to be in a relationship, but they want something on the side. So I think that's where that comes in. I personally don't agree with it. Just because even when you're going on sites like that, at one point, either you or the other person is going to get attached to that person, you know, through sex or, you know, building some kind of bond. So it gets a little messy, but I don't think people really realize that once they really get into that and once they start to reach out to other ways to basically cheat and mess around.
Do you think that cheating is more common in big cities?
Yes. Well, yes and no, just because New York is such a big city, so you could be dating somebody in Brooklyn and cheating in Manhattan. It's so many different slices of the pie here, you know, so many different people to date. But even in smaller cities, I've seen it where people cheat, but they don't talk about it in the smaller cities. It's not really talked about here. It's more so talked about because even though the city is big, it's still kind of small when you kind of do different things. But I feel like it's a big melting pot, and it's a lot of different specimens and appetizers on the menu. So I think it's both, honestly. It just depends on the person.
Not necessarily a thing of the past. I think it's very circumstantial. It depends on who you are, you know? I mean, personally, like, I think monogamy is, for me, I think it's important, but at the same time, like, I wouldn't be totally opposed to being in a polyamorous relationship.
And do you think that your partner should tell you that that's what they're interested in, like, in the beginning?
Yeah, of course. I think it's same with, like, I think it's equatable to, like, fetishes, kinks. Like, I think that you should, if you're in order to have a healthy sexual relationship, at least, I think you should be very open and honest with your partner about what makes you feel good.
Monogamy all the way.
Can I take a second?
It just seems that cheating has become so popular that I wonder if that should be expected nowadays, or is monogamy still something valued?
I think monogamy is a good ideal, but maybe not such a reasonable expectation, or maybe not such a common thing to actually be upheld.
Do you think that it's unrealistic to think that one person could be with someone for the rest of their life?
I think it's a little bit unrealistic, but I think that it's a good ideal to strive for.
What's going on?
I'm asking people their views on monogamy.
What's monogamy?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's one girl, one man. Right?
Yes.
You can't do nothing but commit adultery and fornication. It's rigged, man. They gave him to the bound. Nobody knows. The face of the devil.
Do you think it's unrealistic for one person to be with another for the rest of
the life? I ain't asking you, trying to take your soul. Not one in the Bible says, I want your soul. Never did God say, I want your soul. I want your everlasting. I want your beauty and the bountiful. And the girls, somebody took them on the church too. Good question. Anything else, monogamy?
Thank you so much.
Diana Ross, huh? Have a good day, Mahogany.
I said the same thing. I'm starting to believe that no one wants to believe that monogamy is the thing. And everybody's comparing men to animals and that the animal kingdom is not monogamous. And so now it's so okay. But I was raised on the Bible and I know there's someone out there who wants to be monogamous. So I believe it, but
no, I think you just need to find a person. You have to have a conversation with them and see if that's what they want. Certain people are not interested in that, and you can't make them. You can't force them, and it's not necessarily something that they're ever going to grow into. So I just feel like you both need to be upfront about it. And if you want to be open in a relationship and both of you are okay with that, you should do that. But if not, you should not try to force that person into being into the same mindset. Just go find someone else.
Now, how about when you think you're in a monogamous relationship and then you find out your husband is either on Ashley Madison or on Tinder or sleeping with a nanny?
And how would you know?
Never be able to be 100% sure, because there's always women who say, my husband would never. And those are exactly ones who are on Ashley Madison. So there's no 100% way to find out and to be sure that you are not, or that you are in a monogamous relationship one way or the other.
Right. You can't just assume that. I wouldn't say you can just blindly walk around saying that. If you have a relationship where you have good communication with your partner and you're
maybe
talking to them, you would hope that's better.
Social media has made it so easy. You got cell phones, and most of us want to say we don't want to look in our husbands, our boyfriends, our whoever's phones, or you don't want them looking in your phone. But you have people who you are cheating with mentally and physically. So how do you ever stop that?
Yeah, that's tough. You just have to have be upfront about what you what. But even do you want them to receive pictures or not? Is that a problem? Is that cheating to you?
And if you look at most men's phones, whether they're married or not, they all receive naked photos or photos in bathing suits.
All of them.
Mostly every man has a picture on his phone of some woman. You have no pictures of nobody like I on your
if I'm talking to someone who's a friend and they want to send me like a dick pic, I'm gonna let them know. I don't want to see that.
Don't send it, and it should be automatic respect. It should be automatic respect. It shouldn't be like the world is just so accepting of it that we send these to everybody.
Right.
It should be like, oh, so and so is in a relationship. I'm not gonna send her this pic. But the problem is, people will say, I'm in a relationship. I'm not dead. So you understand? You're never gonna. I don't know. That question that will never get answered.
There you go.
So now you brought up a good point that if you're in a relationship with someone and they are looking to have, like, say, like a polyamorous relationship, they should tell you. But what if you're on the whole, like, notion that, oh, he's with me, I'm with him, you know, and that's it, and then you find out that maybe...
For me, that's a nightmare. That's something that I wouldn't want you to feel like you'd have to hide that. If that's legitimate, what you're interested in, and it's not just you trying to cheat, but you actually, you're trying to have full relationships with multiple people at the same time, that's a different conversation. That's not for me, but there is a woman, or there are women out there who that would be for them.
There's another website, too, that now all of a sudden these men are in relationships and they're dating people on these other websites. It was in that show, because you know there's a new show called Players Get Played, because it's about relationships and how these men are dating 3 and 4 other women.
I don't see how you make that.
It's on Oxygen. I think it's on Oxygen. And they're swearing that they're in these relationships for 3, 4, 5 years monogamously, and they're finding out that these people are in relationships elsewhere also. But
that's crazy. Well, you brought up a good point. Women do cheat too. So now...
Women cheat differently. Women cheat because their man is not accepting of them, maybe emotionally. Because women are more emotional than anything.
You're cheating and it's just about sex.
I know, but I'm saying it takes a minute for them to get to that point. Where men just cheat because there's just other women out there, there's other booty and there's other tits and stuff out there. They have no real reason. If right now, if you said that your wife did everything for you, you still would cheat. Because it's just out there.
If you had the opportunity to cheat, would you?
My daughter, so you better not say that on camera. That's gonna come back and get you.
Speaking, I have cheated before, and it hasn't been a result of I can just go get some ass. It's been a compounding of emotional issues that haven't been resolved, and those, it's like it kind of led to like a lack of trust. That has then been.
I'm the person that you were cheating.
So it's kind of like it was grounded in an emotional trust, something missing from the relationship that wasn't being well communicated, that was then found in other relationships with other people, that then led to cheating. It's not just the I can go have sex because sex is awesome. I'm not calling it an excuse.
Either woman know about the other woman.
Neither woman knew about the other one. That's why it's still cheating. Like, I'm not denying that it was cheating. It was cheating. Like, I'm just saying it wasn't just grounded in, I can just go put my penis in anything. It was, it's not always just because men can have sex, they choose to do so. Because women can also have sex if they choose to do so. I mean, I will say in society standards, it's more quote unquote acceptable and more considered a norm that men cheat and do and are more sexually promiscuous. But I'm sure if we actually took a poll and actually looked at how often people cheat, it's probably neck and neck, or more so neck and neck than we think it is. So it's not just about men wanting to put their dick in anything and wanting to procreate mass rampantly. I'm sure there are other factors that play into it as well.
Reason is because they just can do it.
But I have girls that are friends who it's not emotional. It's just it's for sex or it's for money. Like this guy he pays my phone bill, and this guy like he lays it down in a way that my other third guy doesn't do, and that's all it is for them. And that seems like it's an anomaly for women, but maybe it's not.
Because you have men who do that too. Men who are sleeping with women for money too.
Now your friends that you say they sleep with different guys for different reasons. Do the guys know about this?
No, but the types of guys, from what I've gleaned in hearing about them and meeting some of them, I think they have other women. So
they're both just using each other. Everybody's just using each other for the next
thing. Because you don't actually know. Right. All you know, the guy could be in a situation thinking it's monogamous.
The question is, really, are they considering themselves in relationships? Or is it just that, are we just kind of buddy-buddy, we just do this together, and we're kind of girlfriend-boyfriend, but we're not really boyfriend-girlfriend, so it's okay, you do what you do and I do what I do? Or are you in a committed relationship that you really swear you're in a relationship?
Right, because there's like no, some people feel like it's either, sometimes if it's not on social media, it's not real. So guys are walking around being like, well, I never put you up on my page. I never said we were together, so I thought you knew. Some women do the same thing.
Social media is the dumbest thing ever for relationships.
It is.
It's the biggest havoc-causing thing on earth right now. It's the fact that you can have a whole secret family and nobody would know it.
Okay, so this is Come in the Sun. It's a bottle of sunscreen. It's 30 SPF sunscreen in the shape of a penis. And the idea is you squeeze the balls squirts out.
Okay, can you demonstrate that? Oh, this one is.
I'll open this one. So it comes in a very, you know, environmentally friendly, very safe sealant, and you peel it open like so, and then you have the bottle, and the top pops open just a little bit. I see you looking. You're interested. And what it does is it squirts.
Oh!
Be careful. It dribbles out a little bit. It comes fast.
Wow.
Yeah. And then it seals up again nice, and it's a very good SPF. It's good for your skin. It's FDA approved in Maine and Florida.
So what made you decide to have this bottle shape?
Well, I saw that there was an opening in the market, so to speak. There was no sunscreen in the shape of a penis. And when you get a bunch of guys out at the beach together, and you're like, hey, buddy, do my back, it always ends up becoming like an orgasm, you know? And I figure it's good for couples, too, maybe. But mostly it's for the bros.
For the guys. I thought you were going to try to market it to women, so it have like a dual purpose or something.
Women like it for like bachelorette parties and stuff, but no one's really bought it for a sex toy yet. Mostly because the top comes off, and they say that anything that can come off, like, you shouldn't put inside you because then you'll lose it.
Good point.
So that's Come in the Sun. It's available online and in Ricky's.
Come in the Sun.
Yeah, because your skin comes first.
I love it. I love that line. Okay. So now, my question about monogamy. What do you think about it? Do you think it's something of the past, or we should still value it?
I think that as a species, we should value it. Because it seems to be something that people need and want. You know, our oldest traditions are based on it. But I think that it's not for everybody. I think that it's something that should be an open conversation between partners. Monogamy is right for some people. It's not right for other people. In terms of, I think it's dead or done. No, I don't think so.
Because some people think it's unnatural for somebody to believe that they could be with one person for the rest of their life.
It's hard to say what's natural or not. I mean, swans, they mate for life, right?
Penguins
mate for life. You know, that's pretty natural. I think a lot of humans do mate for life, but humans are more complex than swans and penguins. You know, we have this whole other psyche going on up here. That, you know, maybe some of us want to be monogamous, but some of us just want to have sex with everything and everyone. And I think that there's some correlation between higher brain function and monogamy. The higher brain function you are, the less monogamous you are. So if you have like a 30 IQ, chances are you're going to be with the love of your life forever. But if you're sporting a 150, you're going to be out at all the swinger clubs.
Good point. Okay. How about options? Do you think options comes into factor? Like, in a big city, you have a lot of options to cheat, where you could be less monogamous because you have all these options around.
I don't know. That's a tough question. There are options everywhere, but I think that if you're going to cheat, you're going to cheat, and if you're not, you're not.
Monogamy is unrealistic, or it should be valued?
I don't know. I think it should be valued, but I also see, like, room for like plurality in relationships. I think open relationships can work. I think open marriages can work. And I think we'll see, like, as we go into the future, that more and more people are gonna be like shifting toward having more
polyamorous relationships.
Yeah, or at least poly-ish. You know, maybe not like having relationships with others, but open. You know, and just like embracing that, like, we're kind of like attracted to more than one person, even though you have like a connection with someone and they could be a primary partner, you can love others. So, yeah.
Now, do you think this is something that should be discussed early on in a relationship? Like, hey, I want to have a...
Yeah. If you know what you want in a relationship, it should definitely be discussed right in the beginning. Yeah, that way there's no misconceptions or room for deceit or anything like that. And that way everything is out on the table and you can go from there.
I think it's not a thing of the past. I think it's something... Depends. There are people that like cheese, other people don't like cheese. So people like monogamy, other people don't like it. If you are honest about it, well, there is no problem, but it's about honesty.
Do you think that monogamy is dead or it should be valued today?
I think it's dead. No, for real though. I think it, you know, as a monogamous man, that it's alive and well. And whether it's like against our, you know, common nature as human beings, I guess that's up to fate to decide.
Right now, there's a popularity in sites for people who want to cheat, like married people who want to cheat. Do you think that monogamy is dead or it should be cherished, or what are your views?
I think monogamy is still fine. I don't think it's dead. I think people want to cheat because they are not happy in their relationships. So if you're married and you don't love or you don't want to stay any longer with your partner, yes, break up with her, break up with him, and go away, walk away on your own and make your life. And don't make her life or his life miserable. And then that's what I think.
Do you think husbands and wives should talk to their spouses to tell them that they're looking to sleep with somebody else?
That might be a step before breaking up. But to be honest, I think if my wife would tell me that, that would piss me off, and I wouldn't be happy with that at all. And that's better than breaking up, maybe. So if both of them are happy with that, but I think people, when they have a relationship, they are married, or even if they are not married, they mean to have only one person in their life. So they don't mean to have like several relationships. So I think that's not the right way. So better keep your own partner and not having another ones, or just break up with her, with him, and make your own life.
Hi, I'm Chloe Fontain, and you're watching The Buzz on DPTV Networks. Today, I was in Union Square asking people their views on monogamy. From the responses, it seems that monogamy is alive and well. However, polygamy is to be looked at. What are your views? Let me know. Go to dptvnetworks.com and let me know. I'm Chloe Fontain. See you soon.